The Buckram reeled as rumor after rumor flooded in, following the fall of Fydok Castle. The leader of their enemy, a youth scarce old enough to shave, their owner Buna Branton, a man unworthy of their trust. The Dark Knights routed. But above all else, the news that King Dorgalua's daughter still lived. In their desperation, the people wept. They yearned for a righteous leader, a savior to bring them prosperity. The Lady Kashua was the answer to their prayers. Lancelot Tartaros, mouthpiece of the Holy Lodician Empire, recognized Kashua as the rightful heir to the Valyrian throne. The quarrel over succession was officially laid to rest. By Lancelot's accounting, this prior unrest, as he named it, stemmed not from a deep-rooted divide between clans, but instead from the misdeeds of a handful of power-hungry men. The history books would speak of no great Valyrian war. Yet only the landed and the nobility paid any service to Lancelot's tale. For those who resented the ascendancy of the Buckram, words made a poor sound. While the lie of the battlefield had changed, the war raged on. What had once been seen as a clash of clans became a rift between rulers and the ruled, a struggle to break free from the yoke of oppression.
You still live. Leave us.
Can you hear that, Knight of Zenobia?
It is only a matter of time before you fall.
Who rules in Valyria is a trifling matter. You of all people must understand this.
Let me guess. Unable to stem the tide that rises from the hamlets and villages?
Perhaps we ask too much of the Buckram soldiers. They're not the soldiers we are, you know. Or the men.
Always binding people to your will. Fettering them lest they show signs of free thought. Perhaps therein lies your problem.
They ask for a stern hand to rule them.
They ask. You're mad.
You have it wrong. It is the world that is mad. Tell me, how many of these peasants would even lift a hand to better their lot were they given a chance? How many would bloody their hands, risk their necks, walk without leaning upon another? How many would dare to fight? Think back to your own uprising. Where were the people for whom you shed blood? Safe at their hearths, grousing that more was not done for them.
Times were hard. It was all they could do to keep themselves fed.
Nonsense! They chose to be victims. They think that only from without the castle walls may one voice discontent. Not realizing that the quickest way to the throne is a knife to the king's ribs.
These people have the right to live out their own lives, not fill some part in a play of your design.
You have both your eyes, and yet you see less clearly than I do. True freedom is not granted from above, it is won from below. And yet the commons look without for a savior, even as they claim sovereignty over their own fate. They wait and they wait for their savior, never taking that first step towards saving themselves.
Man is not so slothful a creature as that. They merely lack our strength.
You are much too pure of heart, Holy Knight. The people have no need of dreams. We give them all they need.
And what is that, pray tell?
A strong, unwavering ruler.
You are mad.
All men are born with a terrible burden upon their hearts. This insatiable yearning for pleasure. They do not hesitate to take the lives of others if it will better their own. And yet, even these base creatures can know guilt. So, what do? They turn it around. This is not my fault, man says. The world has failed me. Someone must bring order to this chaos. If the commons want to pursue their pleasure, let them do it in our service, under our rule.
You call this rule? This trampling underfoot of all who disagree with you?
We trample no one. All we do is reach beneath the suppurating flesh of this world and wrench out the source of its ailment.
No. As the body strives to mend itself, so does the heart. These people you so despise may one day astonish you with their valor.
You have far too much faith in the creature called Man, Knight. People are drawn to power, drawn towards safety. They will betray even their most beloved to obtain it. Kashua, come.
Kashua, what are you doing here?
Allow me to introduce to you your liege, Knight. For this girl is none other than the gift left us by Dynast King Dogalua, the Princess Versalia, rightful ruler of Valeria.
What?
Well, as you say, the Buckram are not long for this world. But with the princess in our hands, Valeria will beg to serve under Lodus.
Kashua, how? Is this true?
I love Denon. As my brother, I loved him. But he was no brother to me. He abandoned me. And now, I him.
Kashua!
Though it pains me to part with the man who took my eye, I see no need to further torment the vanquished. Farewell.
Wait!
Farewell, Knight of Zenobia.
The princess has not been seen since the ceremony. Not even the officers among the Buckram know her whereabouts, and the regent has lent his spies to the search. I see no other explanation but that the princess has sided with the Dark Knights.
Then the rift between Branton and Tartaros widens. What word of the Dark Knights?
Most remain garrisoned in Heim. But many of their commanders, including Tartaros, are conspicuously absent.
Perhaps this is why the Buckram do not move against us. What could they be scheming?
You asked me to search for the Holy Knight of Zenobia.
Yes. Have you heard something?
A confession wrung from a scullery maid. It seems that the Holy Knight languishes in the dungeon below Heim Castle.
So he lives?
Yes. But under such a guard that not even the Buckram are allowed near, I was unable to mark him with my own eyes.
Still, you have done much. Go, rest.
By your leave, Commander.
Kashua.
Commander, should we not move our forces on Heim?
Not as yet. It would be rash indeed to strike without first knowing the Dark Knight's purpose.
Yes, but the more time that passes before we strike, the weaker we become. Have you forgotten the way the men speak of the princess? Soldiers in your own ranks weep aloud at the thought of lifting a sword against Orgalua's blood.
I know. All the more reason to not act in haste.
A report, sir.
What is it?
The soldiers at Brigantis have taken hostages and holed up inside the castle.
What's this?
What are their demands?
Our surrender to the Bakram, sir.
After all the fighting we've been through? Not bloody likely.
So the Order of Falaha joins the fray. Their followers among the soldiers were many, were they not?
Aye. And their influence has only grown since the princess's appearance.
Not a situation we are like to change. The princess's arrival was, for many, the advent of a savior. Add to this the fact that the late Dynast King was a fervent follower of Falaha. How natural for these new converts to rekindle his cry for accord and seek to abandon the fight.
What will you do?
I see no other choice but to meet with these followers of Falaha and speak with them.
Out of the question! It's too dangerous, Commander!
Not if I go alone and unarmed. They will hear me out.
Look around! Thank you. day. Farewell.
Why, hello there.
Thank you.
Don't stay away long.
I've looked forward to our meeting, Denim of Goliath. You will pay for your crimes against Golgastan with your life!
Thank you. Thank you.
bastards killed me.